Hey guys, I wanted to make this quick tutorial to show how to link the Bazaar application with your network attached storage. I've looked through some of the wiki and I couldn't find a clear explanation as to how to get Bazaar working. This is now I should say that this is how I did it. It may or may not work on your machine and your setup, okay? And I'm sure I've made mistakes along the way. However, it is working for me. So, this tutorial is not going to go in depth as I don't want it to be 20 minutes. This is primarily just, a point and click and do this tutorial. So, first thing you want to do is you want to install the application on your Windows machine. Okay, so head over to this link. I'm going to leave it down in the description below and download the Bazaar installer. Okay, download it and install it. Now, by default, this will be installed in your C drive, okay, as a service on your Windows machine. So once the application is installed, and you can verify that by heading over into your C drive Bazaar folder, this is where majority of it's going to live. So the first thing you want to do once it's installed is we want to head over to our task manager and find the services tab, scroll down to Bazaar, and then hit open services. Once you're here, you want to scroll down to Bazaar again, double click it, and head over to the log on tab. By default, Bazaar will be this will be selected as the default option. Now, this may or may not work. And so to get around this, you want to hit this account and select and then type in dot forward slash and then your account name with administrative privileges. Punch in your password and then hit apply. Now, when you hit apply, there will be a window that will say that a restart is required. Go ahead and right click on the service, hit restart, and all of your changes should be applied at that point. Now, on to the next step. So if your service is running, you should be able to go to your local host 6767 local host semicolon 6767, and you can see that my service is already running. So I'm fetching all of this all of these shows and movies from my radar and Bazaar. Sorry, from my radar and sonar. Now, in order for all of this to work, and this is what I or at least I think where a lot of people struggle. The very first thing you want to do is you want to head down to your settings, and depending on which service you're setting up, whether it's sonar or radar, but let's just pick sonar as an example. Of course, you're going to want to put your API key in that you find from Sonar. But once that's done, the mappings need to be set up correctly in order for Bazaar to start fetching. So, what I mean by that, once you put your API key in and you save this page, this window down here will be blank. So you can add a lot more mappings, as many mappings as you want, but initially it will be blank. And so on the left-hand side, we're going to want to include the location of where all of the NAS multimedia lives. Okay. On the right-hand side, however, we need to add the location of where the Bazaar application will point all of the data to. Okay. Now, I know this sounds confusing, but let me elaborate. So, if you head over to your PC, and depending on how your system's set up, but this is how my system's set up. So, all of my Plex media lives on a mapped drive, okay? So, when you go over to this ribbon up here and hit the three dots, you have a couple of ways to add drives in your PC. So, when my Plex server fetches information. It looks at this Plex storage drive, okay? And the way you add it is you hit map network drive and it goes through all these windows to sign a drive letter, and it shows up as this little server here, okay? So this location is where. So basically, what you're gonna do is you're gonna copy and paste essentially this path into the sonar column, okay? Now on the Bazaar side, it's a little different. And I'm not gonna go into all the details as to why it's different, but here's how you set that side up. So instead of mapping a network drive, we want to add a network location, okay? So when you add a network location, and it's the exact same procedure as how you would do the mapped network drive, but however, let me just use this as an example. So if I wanted to add, say, Plex storage and then the movies folder, this is how I would do it. Must have spelled it wrong. Plex and iMovies. Right? So if I wanted to add the Plex server as an example, this is how you would do it. Okay? I'm just showing this as an example. So you can see that I've added this folder now. So in order for Bazaar to work correctly, this is what you need to do. You need to add the parent directory where all of your movies live. So then you want to head back over to the web UI, go into Sonar, scroll all the way down, and I'm not going to remove my existing path, but I will show you what you want to do. So the left-hand side will remain the same, right? But on the right-hand side, you're going to type in the IP address of the machine for the folder that you just added in your PC, and then pointed to your shows directory at this IP address. Scroll up, hit save. And that's it. Once you have this mapping set up and you have both of these folders, both the map network drive and the added network location, your Bazaar should begin working as long as you have the providers set up. Okay. So you can see I've got six different providers set up. It's rather simple to do that. You just hit this plus sign and then select the provider that you want to add. Now, the one thing I should mention is some of them will require accounts. I just don't add those. Like you can see this one requires a username and password. I just skip those and I go and find one that doesn't require one that doesn't require any account. So I just added this pod. And then the other thing you want to do is you want to add a language profile. Okay. So head over to languages, add new profile, and give it a name, add a language, and I hit save. And then once that's done, that's pretty much it. Your Bazaar should start pulling information from your providers and adding it to your Plex server. If you guys have any questions or run into any issues, feel free to contact me. I will try and help you out as much as I can. And I'll catch you on the next one.